The bell on a Bach trumpet goes through many steps to acquire its classic shape and the unique Bach sound. We start with a single piece of stamped brass and give it curves. Our bell specialist brings the two edges together to create a seam and hammers along the length of the metal. One piece construction lets the bell vibrate without restriction. It's all part of the famous Bach Strad sound. Fusion paste seals the seam as he brazes it. The torch can exceed 2,000 degrees. That's as hot as molten lava. Vincent Bach discovered that the best sounding bells are not a uniform thickness. We create slight variations in the thickness of the bell's walls. We also heat treat our trumpets. This tempering process, known as annealing, is part of the Bach secret sauce. We shape the bell around a solid steel mandrel. Scribing the end of the bell trims off excess metal. The artisan pulls back the brass around the outside edge of the bell. We don't stop there, though. Watch while a wire ring is added to the inside of the rim. The ring helps keep the bell from collapsing. Forcing solder into the rim increases the bell's responsiveness. Details like these can have a dramatic impact on how the bell resonates and are part of what creates the distinctive Bach sound. The shape of the flare matters too. Some Bach bells taper fast. They become wider right away, producing a dark, mellow sound. Other bells taper slow, widening gradually, and produce a brighter sound. Vincent Bach made drawings for more than 76 different bell designs for the B-flat trumpet alone. We don't use all of them now, but we still rely on his original designs. Bach, craftsmanship, attention to details, creating the unique Bach sound, making legends. We use only the highest quality brass for our trumpets. Drawing brass doesn't mean sketching a picture of it. It means inserting a hardened steel rod called a mandrel inside a length of tubing and pulling or drawing rod and tubing together through a steel ring. Drawing determines the bore size of the trumpet. Bore size is the width of the inside of the brass tubing, or its inside diameter. Changes in bore size as small as the width of a human hair can affect airflow, resistance, and ultimately, tone. The length of the lead pipe turns the vibration you start at your mouthpiece into the standing waves we hear as music. Only the best. The science of sound. Think of the valves, pistons, valves, and casings as the heart of a trumpet. Valves act like fingers on a hand. The casing acts like a glove around them. We created a valve casing fixture to make sure all of the pieces of this heart stay in position during brazing. Trumpet players don't want any air to leak past pistons. Vincent Bach discovered in the 30s that Monel, a hard nickel alloy, created a tight fit while letting pistons move freely. After we braze the valve cluster, we solder it to the three tuning slides. The third valve slide ring helps you play notes like low D and C sharp in tune by letting you extend the third valve slide. Even this small ring takes 7 steps to make. 7 of the 465 total steps that go into making a Bach trumpet. Vincent Bach designed the main tuning slide on his trumpets in a distinctive D shape. We still use the same D shape for our tuning slides and Monel for our pistons, and craftsmen and women in the Bach plant continue to create innovative manufacturing solutions. A century of tradition and innovation, making legends. A trumpet is played by blowing or buzzing through a hollow tube to create a moving column of air, a standing wave. The good vibration starts with the lips and a mouthpiece. At Bach, great manufacturing also starts with mouthpieces. We take solid brass bars and place them in a computer-controlled machine that meticulously shapes and cuts the bars into mouthpieces.We program the machine so that each step, trimming the brass bars, shaping the rim, creating the mouthpiece shank that fits into the lead pipe, is precise within 1/1000th of an inch. We call it precision manufacturing. The history of Bach trumpet starts with mouthpieces too. A century ago, trumpet player Vincent Bach needed to replace a ruined mouthpiece and began experimenting with designs and manufacturing processes. Mouthpieces led to trumpets. Bach's pleased customers told him, "Vincent, this is the Stradivarius of trumpets." That's how Bach's trumpets acquired a name from the legendary Italian violin maker Stradivarius, a name synonymous with the very best.Our Stradivarius trumpets are still based on Bach's original designs. In the Bach plant today, we proudly continue the tradition of American-made excellence. Every day, we inspect 1,000 trumpet mouthpieces, marking any irregularities. Only mouthpieces that meet our high standards go on Bach trumpets. Proud to be Bach. It takes 465 steps to make a Bach trumpet. 35 people in our plant put together more than 120 separate parts. Here's where they come together. We solder the slides to valve clusters.Put together tuning slides. We engrave the number of the mandrel used to shape the taper of the bell above Vincent Bach's signature. We buff each horn. Check the action of the pistons.And the smoothness of the slides. We buff again. Lacquer, electroplate, clean. We assemble each trumpet twice. And we test it all together twice. We stand behind every instrument we make.Our tester sets the opening of the lead pipe and also reams the mouthpiece receiver so the mouthpiece is an exact distance from the lead pipe. He checks pistons and slides, checks for air leaks, and plays.